Welcome to XS Training's new training facility, where we can carry out more installation, bigger floor area for workshop areas and classroom facilities. So when putting a thread onto the conduit, we're going to be using a stock and die. And we've put on there a little bit of cutting compound, normally Treflux. And to get it started, apply a little bit of pressure. We normally go two turns and then half back. One, two, half back. One, two, half back. And you just want the threads coming through, two or three threads showing, depending on the length that you want that thread, but half a coupling is normally two threads that are popping through there. So we can now just apply the coupling there on the end of the thread. And to ensure earth continuity throughout, just make sure the coupling is nice and tight. So let's apply the accessory. So just tightening up the brass bush to ensure that we have that earth continuity throughout. Like I say, we do get bush spanners that we can use, but two pairs of grips are absolutely fine, and that's nice and tight. So any fault currents that do touch the back box will then connect through to the coupling and the whole system. As long as it's continuous, any fault currents can be taken away. So when we're putting a 90 degree bend in there, wherever your line is, that will be the back of the bend. So as that piece of tube comes down, that line that we've got there will be the back of the tube. So that will be from wall to roof. Okay, so we put a marker in there, we set that, pull your lever up, set your mark so it's on the back of the former there. The stop's got it in place. Bend that down until we've got a 90 degree angle. That's not far off. There we have it, 90 degree bend. So that'll be flush to the wall there, boom, comes out and then into there.